Vrindavan. After the repeated attacks of demons, Yashoda was worried about the safety of Lord Krishna. "We must move away from Gokul," said Yashoda to Nanda worriedly. "Why should we do that?" asked the chief of the cowherds. "Nanda, if we live here, there might be more demon attacks on Krishna." "I'm afraid for him," said Yashoda. "Our son is not an ordinary human, so why worry?" asked Nanda. "We already know this, but he is just a young boy," replied Yashoda. Then Yashoda recollected and narrated how Lord Krishna's mouth contained the entire universe and how he had defeated dangerous demons. Nanda agreed to move to Vrindavan for his son's safety. Both husband and wife, along with Lord Krishna and Balram, moved to lush Vrindavan. Yashoda was content in the hope that her son would be safe in Vrindavan, though she knew he was the divine Lord himself. Lord Krishna plays pranks. As time passed, Lord Krishna and Balram grew up into strong and happy children. Lord Krishna would always be dressed in yellow garments while Balram was attired in blue clothes. Yashoda would often watch them from the corner of her eyes just to reassure herself that they were fine. One day, a gopi came to complain to Yashoda. "Kanhaiya is very naughty," said the unhappy gopi. Lord Krishna was well loved by all and he was affectionately called Kanhaiya by the gopis. "What did my Krishna do?" asked Yashoda. The gopi complained, "When I went to milk the cow in the morning, I saw that someone had untied the calf. The little calf had reached the cow and drunk all the milk. As I looked around to catch the culprit who untied it, I saw your son smiling mischievously at me," said the gopi. Yashoda understood how clever and compassionate her son was. Lord Krishna steals curd. One day, an irritated gopi entered Lord Krishna's home. "Mother Yashoda, your child Krishna is a thief," she thundered. "Why do you call him a thief?" asked Yashoda. No sooner were the words out of her mouth than the gopi started complaining bitterly. "I tied a pot of curd from the ceiling so that no one might eat it. Krishna came into the house and broke the pot with a stone. He ate the curd and even gave some to his naughty friends," said the dismayed gopi. "Do not despair, O gopi. I will keep a close watch over my son and keep him from stealing your curd," promised Yashoda. With great difficulty and many pleas, she was finally able to reassure the gopi. She continued to marvel at how clever her little son was. Lord Krishna became more adept at stealing butter and curd as time passed. Lord Krishna and his friends. Whenever Yashoda felt that her son had finally stopped playing tricks, Lord Krishna played yet another prank on an unsuspecting gopi. The unhappy girl came to Yashoda to complain about this. "Kanhaiya has done it again," complained the gopi as she approached Mother Yashoda. Without even waiting for her to say a word, the gopi plunged into bitter complaints. "I tied a pot of butter high above the ground so that no one might touch it. When my back was turned, Kanhaiya along with his friends made a pyramid and reached the pot. They helped themselves to the butter and I only saw them leaving because I turned around at that moment," complained the gopi. "When I asked Kanhaiya about this, he said maybe a cat ate the butter." Yashoda did not know which way to look when she heard this. Yashoda scolds Krishna. Yashoda was very unhappy about the complaints regarding Lord Krishna which she got from the gopis. "Oh Krishna, look how the gopis are complaining about you," said Yashoda. Lord Krishna, who was standing in the corner, looked sadly at her. Big teardrops rolled down his cheeks as he felt sad for his mother. Hearing him cry, all the gopis came to the house. Seeing his tears and his sad, innocent face, the gopis started to protect him. "Please do not scold Kanhaiya," one of the gopis pleaded with Yashoda. Another tried to reason. "He is only a little child. Please do not blame him. As everyone loved him dearly, no one wanted to see him cry. And even Yashoda could not bring herself to scold him anymore." Lord Krishna stopped crying and became happy again. The deep affection that the gopis felt for him grew stronger as time passed.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.